Welcome to Polyhymnia's Studio 2, our analog remastering room. This is where the process starts. We're remastering Beethoven symphonies with Leonard Bernstein and the Vienna Phil. Most of those, the first eight symphonies, were recorded on one-inch analog tape. This is a fantastic format with a lot of tape, as you can see, for the signal. And it was sort of the pinnacle of analog recording technology just before digital came in 1978 and 79. We're using fantastic machines here for the tape transport, Studer A80. We think this is probably the best machine ever made in terms of mechanics, but the electronics, maybe not quite so good. That's why they're missing. We've replaced the Studer electronics with our own. We're using our custom Polyhymnia microphone preamplifiers as head amplifiers. The signal comes directly from the playback head here to these modified microphone amplifiers. We can adjust the gain and the high frequency EQ, and the tape EQ, which is required, is also done within these circuit boards. From there, the signal goes to these Dolby A noise reduction units. Dolby A is a noise reduction system which during recording compresses the signal in four different frequency bands, and then in playback that has to be decompressed so that you have the right signal but with less noise. There's an interesting story about those as well, because these cards were made especially for Philips. Philips and Deutsche Grammophon had their own cards from Dolby. They weren't happy with the stock cards. So we're lucky to have those here, which are probably the same cards, types of cards that the tapes were originally recorded with. An interesting story to tell about the Studer A80. A long time ago, when I was still in Boston, we only had one Studer A80, and it could be changed from either quarter inch to half inch. This one's set up as half inch now. And to do that, you changed all the rollers and the head block. The head block comes off as one piece. Not a huge job. I did that. Took all the half-inch parts off, put them in a bag, and worked on half-inch tapes for a while. A couple of weeks later, I had to put the quarter-inch parts back on, and they didn't fit. The pitch roller wouldn't go back on, and I couldn't figure it out. They'd been stored carefully in a plastic bag, but it turns out there was a little tiny black corroded fingerprint on the shaft. And after taking that off with a touch of emery paper, the parts fit again. Shows the incredible precision that these machines were machined to. Before we can start transferring the tapes, we have to line up the machines. That's done with a special test tape. And it involves a couple of different parts. First is an electronic lineup. We need to make sure that the levels are all the same, also for different frequencies, adjusting the high frequency equalization. But we also have to make sure that the head is perfectly lined up to the tape, absolutely perpendicular. If it's not, you get phase problems with high frequencies, and actually you lose high frequency information as well. So first I'm going to just check with a 1 kHz tone that the levels are close. Now they're off a little bit, so I'll go through channel by channel and adjust them slightly to get them all close to the zero point. As you can see, I've got the meters on an incredibly high scale, so they're bouncing around a little bit. Okay, you can see here when I play these tones that the phase scope is showing a straight line. Okay, now we have a higher frequency tone. And as I adjust the azimuth, you'll see it moves into a circle and straight. Now I'll do this with all the tones and double check. There we go. Now these high frequency tones are recorded at a lower level on the test tape, because otherwise they'd saturate. And you can see these are also not well lined up. I'll do the azimuth again, a little bit, just a tiny bit. With 1-inch tape, it always moves around a tiny bit, but that's pretty good. Now look at the high frequency equalization. Channel 2 is clearly slightly low. I can boost that up a bit. Channel 1 is a bit too hot. Okay. I'll just take the test tape back off. I'm going the wrong way. The tapes are stored on pancakes. This is something you have to be careful about. Everyone who's worked with analog tapes has had one of these fall apart on them. Not what we want to have happen with Bernstein's masterpieces. So let me take this off. Put that on the side for now. And here is one of the actual original session tapes from 1978, I believe. This is Beethoven's Third Symphony, recorded in the Musikverein, 4th through 6th February 1978. So I'll put it on, and we'll see quickly if it's frontwards or backwards. Okay, we got it the right way wrong. Now, this funny sounding tone is the Dolby level. And if we want this to play back correctly, we have to make sure that the signal is exactly on the dots on each track. So we'll adjust the levels very slightly to get these all lined up on the dot. And then our Dolbies will track properly. All right. There we go. All under the dots. Everything's lined up. We're ready to go. Let me go back just a second. Here you can see edits. As I said, these are the original tapes, and you can perhaps just see it here. Bits of tape are stuck together. This symphony wasn't recorded in one piece. A bunch of different takes were played, performed, and afterwards the musicians and the producer decided which parts were to be used, and the tape editor found those bits in the mini reels of original tape and taped them together. Now, we're very lucky that these edits have held up perfectly. We hadn't had a single one fail, which is pretty amazing for tapes that are about 40 years old. So the sticky tape was a good batch. Now, here's the beginning of the symphony. Turn the volume up a bit. All right, now it's time for the actual transfer. I'm going to record into PureMix, not changing anything at all during the record process. We're making straight transfers, no analog compression, no equalization, trying to get everything on the tape into PureMix, into the digital domain, and store it onto our servers next door. You'll see later that there is actually information on these tapes above 20 kilohertz, which would go on to CD. We're recording at 352 kilohertz, 8 times the CD rate. So we'll capture all of that information that was lost up until now in the digital domain. Let me start PureMix. We're recording. Zoom in a bit. Yep. And start the machine. And here we have the documentation from the sessions and from the mixing, telling us which instruments are on which tracks, how they were panned, and the fader levels. We'll tell you a bit more about that later when we're actually doing the mixing. For now, I can let you hear a little bit of each of the tracks. The woodwinds, flute, and clarinet on the left, and oboes, and bassoons on the right. And I'll go to the strings first. Violins on the left. This is the main microphones. As you can hear, even those are quite close. And then finally, we have the brass and percussion. Of course, I chose a moment where they weren't playing. Just wait a second.